Hello world, I'm Mr. Spaceman. Welcome to my first ever player review on this channel. I wanted to do one of them for a while, and now I have a good reason. We finally have a Russian wonder kid in this game. After a lot of years where we had no representation because our players are kind of bad, we finally have one. Arsen Zakharyan, an amazing player, and this guy is just on a different level. So first of all, this is his stats. Okay, he's already quite decent, but I want to tell you what he has done, and then we'll dive into the full manager stuff. This guy has been chosen by The Guardian in October 2020 in the top 60 of the most exciting youth prospects coming through, born in 2003. And also, he managed to make his debut in a game against Tambov on November 1st, 2020. And in between him being released for this game, he has actually managed to make his first start against, if I'm not mistaken, against Akhmat. In the 7th minute, his cross has led to a penalty that they scored, and he also scored a goal. Yeah, he's already playing in Russia. He's already starting games. This guy's amazing. But now back to Football Manager. Boom! In Football Manager, here we have Arsen Zakharyan. I know it says Din, but that's just because we are also going to do a little experiment. So it's kind of a double video, really. So we're going to find out if players can develop playing in Russia, or it's better for them to start outside of Russia and develop. But let's start from left to right. So technicals, very good at dribbling, very good at finishing, great first touch, pretty good long shots, decent technique. Now, obviously, he's going to be playing in the center position, so the attacking playmakers. So he needs to have some passing. He needs to improve some passing. But apart from that, he's very, very good. As you can see, he's really not defensive-minded with very bad technicals in that area. The tackling, the marking is kind of bad. But if he gets up that passing, so get him, put passing on him straight away, he will be amazing for you. In the mentals, it's quite often that in Russia we have youth who don't have the best mentals. It just happens. But I'm surprised that his determination is 14, so maybe that's good. But again, bravery is okay. Composure is very good. Determination is very, very good. Flair is 12. Beautiful. Teamwork and vision is 12. So again, amazing stuff. I think he already has the makings to be a pretty good advanced playmaker. Perfect physical. So apart from stamina and strength, 13 for acceleration, 12 agility, 12 balance, 13 jumping reach, 13 pace. Very, very good. He's a good player. So the plan is, so here's his version in Dynamo, and here's the exact same player in Borussia Dortmund. I cloned him, but to be nice to him, so he actually has chance, I gave this guy the German nationality, so he has two nationalities. So we'll see what happens to him. He has a chance to play for the German national team or the Russian one. His potential ability is very high. I've tried to match them. They're actually identical. They're identical in everything, but the BVB guy has the nationality. So what we're going to do, we're going to simulate 10 years into the future to see how well Arsen Zakharyan develops. I think in 10 years, he'll be hitting his peak. So it's going to be a good measurement of how well he develops from 17, as you can see these stats, to in 10 years, if he's an amazing player, if he's world-class, or if he's just never developed. Also, as a bonus point, we're going to find out if developing a player in Russia is detrimental to their development. The year is 2030. We're going to start with the guy who started his career in Russia. So Arsen Zakharyan is currently playing in Zenit, and he is a fringe player. As you can see, he has developed slightly. I think his dribbling has gone up, but pretty much everything else has stayed the same. His passing has gone from 8 to 11, which is okay, but his vision has gone up as well. So I can already see that, first of all, his physicals, they were already great to start with, and that's kind of what he improved in, and that's very good. But I don't see huge amounts of improvement, so I can kind of already tell that there is a bit of an issue with developing players in Russia. So what happened? Maybe he didn't get some game time? No, he actually kind of did not. So he played a lot of his career for Dynamo 2, then he played a few games in the first division, made some appearances for Dynamo, I think. Yeah, he did some appearances, left Rubin, did not play much, and still doesn't play much. Okay, so there we go. For some reason, Russia and Russian teams do not trust their youth as much. And it's surprising because Dynamo is actually one of those teams who play their youth quite often. So that is very strange. He has not shown at all. Like, he didn't even shine in the first division or where Dynamo 2 Moscow is, which is very unfortunate. I think this is kind of a wasted opportunity, a wasted chance. He's 27, zero caps, zero goals. I don't think he's gonna get any better. Let's see his current ability. 123 out of 159. Okay, so wow, that is kind of wasted wonder kid there. I mean, we know that a lot of these things can happen, but I mean, that's just football, but I'm still very disappointed, especially that he spent his whole career in Russia. And if you manage to save him from Russia and buy him for your own team, this is how well he develops. Although I say this and he ended up in Russia once again, but that's fine. Look at the difference. He's valued to be much more. He's a regular starter. He actually plays. And Krasnodar is a very good team. For his technicals, mentals, and physicals, they're pretty much a one-up on everything. So he has developed much, much better. If we compare the players, yeah, you can see there's a huge difference. Basically, yeah, he pretty much developed everywhere much better than the Russian guy. So yeah, if you are signing him, You can see you can get a very useful player out of him. Let's see how much they signed him for. I mean, yeah, just looking through it, I don't think he's actually played a game for Dortmund. He's played a game for Dortmund. So he actually played before he left. That's kind of awesome. Played for Tula, Augsburg, not really shining. Played okay in Borussia Dortmund too. Went to Zenit, did nothing. Went to Werder, did nothing. They sold him. And then finally, when he went to Krasnodar, he found his peak. 7.25, 7.07, 7.20. Decent player. Who's actually also an international, and I think he's Russian international. Yeah, Russia declared. Just imagine if he's German international. That'd be kind of cool. But yeah, so this is the kind of player you might be getting from him. But also don't forget, if you have him by yourself, if you're actually training him and doing something, you can do much, much better with him. Especially, look, he's been sent around alone, and that's never good for player development. Look at that, 141 out of 159. Again, he could be better. As you see, there's a lot of space for him to grow. But to be fair, I am looking at this and I'm thinking he could actually make a decent striker as well. So if you are developing this guy, don't be afraid to train him as a striker. He looks a little bit like Timo Werner. He's a very good physical runner. He will do all the running for you. Decent mentals, composure, amazing. Concentration, amazing. Decision, determination, good finishing, good dribbling, good first touch. So if I were to rate him, I would give him a 7.5 out of 10. I think he's a good player. I think he's got lots of room for improvement. And I think if you give him a chance outside of Russia, I think he can do some great stuff there. And as you can see, even doing his own things, even being sent out on loan, all doing all that stuff, he has developed very, very, very well, unless he goes to Russia where he spends his whole life on the bench. So I hope you enjoyed this player review. I want to be doing a bit more, but I want to be doing slightly lesser known or not as popular ones. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a like if you do like this kind of stuff. Comment to tell me which player I should look for, and you know, not the most well-known player, because I think that's kind of cool. And subscribe to my channel. I'm continuing my daily uploads for this month, and which I hope you're enjoying it. It's hopefully good content and not just trash I'm throwing out to pad out the month. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye, guys.